Yeah, hey Philip. I'm here with Philip. He is a master and MBA student from Germany, and his background is actually really interesting. He did his bachelor studies in Germany, and then he worked for a well-known company, actually, Pricewaterhouse, in Germany, and decided, you know, after his great job, to do a master's in MBA in the States. Very interesting. So welcome, Philip.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here. Thank you.
Yeah. So tell me, after your great job at Pricewaterhouse, why did you still decide to do an MBA in the States?
Yeah. So I had a fixed job in financial service consulting after PricewaterhouseCoopers at Capco. But I decided to get an MBA because it's just the door opener for your later career. So when you aspire a management position, an MBA is always in your favor, and you get to get a little bit deeper into the matter, especially in business. And so I decided to get an MBA. The choice of mine was to get an MBA from a German university or a Master's of Science or a US MBA. Mm-hmm. And eventually I decided for US MBA because it's much more practically oriented. In Germany, I think studying in general is much more research heavy, much more academical. When I did my bachelor's degree in Germany, we had this, we had lectures, of course, during the semester, but we only had this one final exam, and your grade is this final exam only. And in the US, you have exams, you have homework, you have essays, you have cases, you have group work you have to do during the entire semester. And I think due to this, you interact with your professors and with the project matter much more closely, and I think you learn a little bit more. At least that's how I see it, and that's why I decided for US MBA, because it's much more hands-on, much more practically oriented.
Yeah, sure. No, I can totally relate. You know, I also did an MBA in the States, and it's definitely way more hands-on. You know, you can always talk to the professors, you know, and it's also like the classes are way smaller, and, you know, you feel like you feel really welcomed in terms of that the university really wants you to pass courses. They really want to help you out. So I can totally relate what you're saying. So now you are in Buffalo, New York. Very interesting. So tell me about that. Like, how did you end up in Buffalo?
Yeah, that was an interesting process. When I decided to do US MBA, I had no preferences whatsoever where to go. So I had the US map in front of me and I was like, okay, where am I going? So I took the top 300 universities or top 50 business schools, and I ranked them among criteria that are important to me, which are, of course, ranking, but also cost of living and tuition. They should be reasonable. My profile should match the profile of the MBA. So I shouldn't be matched with an MBA program, which is only for executives with 20 years of working experience, but with actual students who have a likewise profile. And also climate was kind of important, and also likelihood that I would get accepted into the program. So I made up my mind about these universities, and Buffalo popped up on number one. And then I talked to current students at the university. I took a look at some videos at the website, and yeah, my head and my stomach told me to do it, and I applied, and I got accepted, and now I'm here.
Great. Very cool. Crazy times, Corona, you know, election, all in 2020. Yeah. You're still there. So tell me, why did you not postpone your studies until, let's say, if, you know, maybe next year everything is normal again? I mean, nobody knows. But why did you still decide to start studying now instead of, like, later?
Very interesting question that I have asked myself the past months, but I decided to do it this year because I think the more you get into the working world, the harder it is to actually get out of the working world to get an MBA. Say I continued working for another 2 or 3 years, then of course salary is likely to rise, and also the opportunities are getting bigger and broader. And I think the opportunity cost of going to school again are much higher than now. And I'm closer to university, I'm closer to learning. The younger you are, the easier you are with learning, with learning new things, with studying. So that's why I did it as soon as possible, to be honest, but also having a little bit of working experience. Factor number two was that I think now is a perfect time to get your MBA or to study, because of course the labor market and the economy is in downturn. But I think in 2 years when I graduate, the labor market is going to be very different and a lot better than today. So I think 2022 is a good year to graduate.
Yeah, sounds like a very, very smart move. And yeah, you're also doing a two-year MBA program, right?
Yes.
Yeah, nice. So tell me a little bit about your first weeks in the States, and especially like you live on campus right now. Mm-hmm. How is campus life? And yeah, generally, how are you the first few weeks in the States for you?
Yeah, I've been in the States for 6 weeks now, the first two of which were quarantined, sadly. But I'm glad to be here after all. Campus life is a lot different, obviously, because there are no big football games, no big basketball games. The gyms are shut down. You can only go swimming or running. There are not so many people on campus whatsoever. Campus is open, so you can go to study groups. You can work on campus, which I do. I like to study on campus. And yeah, for a German or generally European student, it's unusually busy in the first weeks, because when you start a study in Germany, usually the first half of the semester you can be a little more laid back, and usually crunch time comes around the finals. But here it's 100% from day one. So we're having assignments and homeworks and cases and for every course, for every week. So we hit the ground running when we start, and it's a lot about time management, getting your priorities straight, setting up a timeline for every course. So it's been a busy first weeks, but I enjoyed it very much.
Great. And tell me a little bit, I mean, as we can see, you sit in your dorm room. With how many people do you live, and how does everything work in campus with food and everything else?
Yeah, I live in a dorm. I live in a on-campus apartment housing. I have two roommates, which are Americans. And food places on campus are still open. I think like 7 out of 10 food places are open. So you can get food anytime you want. Of course, grocery shops and convenience stores are open, so that's not an issue at all on campus. Of course, as I said, there's less students than usual, but still, in your apartment complex, you can get to know new people, you can go to campus. We have a small study group, we go to campus every day or every other day, so you can still have, I don't want to say a normal life, but more normal than maybe the lockdown in March.
Yeah. Great, and then big year, election, how is that for you?
Yeah, it's exciting because you're much closer to it than you would be in Germany. Of course, I think from every country in the world, you're looking at this election this year. But it's much more interesting when you're actually in the country right now. And I think tonight's the first debate, the first set of 4 or 5 presidential debates. Yeah. And this is the big TV event for everybody. So everybody's like, are you watching the debate today? And tomorrow everybody's going to ask, hey, how do you find the debate?
Right.
So it's a very active process. Everybody's involved, obviously. It's a very, everybody's got an opinion. And especially on campus, everybody's got a very strong opinion. But it's nice to see both sides of the story here, because you are exposed to opinions you wouldn't be exposed to in Germany. And that's very, very interesting. And you learn a lot.
Right. Yeah, it sounds like very exciting times for you so far. And tell me, if we go back a little bit in the process, and when we talk about ePro, well, tell me, how did ePro help you, you know, and did they help you the most with? What were you able to achieve through ePro? Tell me a little bit about that, please.
Yeah. ePro has been a partner and like a sparring buddy from A to Z, every step of the way. My first phone call with Jonas was, I think, in August last year or July last year, when I was thinking about doing a US MBA, and Jonas helped to bust some myths about studying in the US and helped to consult me in my decision. And I think the last touch point next to our interview right now was when Amanda was helping me getting everything ready for immigration for my flight to the US. And everything in between, ePro helped me make checklists for every step of the way, for visa, for application, for writing essays, for doing tests. So I think a big value and a big benefit of ePro services are just structuring the process and answering a lot of questions along the way. Because there are a lot of things I wouldn't have thought of if I was doing this process by myself. So I was very thankful for having ePro as a competent partner who answered questions along the way and just thought of everything.
Great. Good to hear that. And then you said within 1 year, you made it to the States, basically, right? From your first touch point with Jonas to the States, mm-hmm. everything within 1 year. And you also mentioned the word myth. Was there like a myth or something that kept you hesitated, you know, something like a mindset blockade, something that ePro was able to, solve?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you have a little bit of prejudices and stereotypes about studying in the US. It's hell of expensive. You can only go there if you're an athlete, very good at sports, barely, and only certain types of universities accept international students. But these are basically wrong. So, and Jonas helped to bust these myths because you can make it even as a non-athlete. I'm not an athlete. I don't have an athlete scholarship, but I got a scholarship from our faculty. And if you make up your mind, there are a lot of universities offering studies for international students and even grants and scholarships exclusively for international students. So it's definitely worth taking a look together with Jonas at what the possibilities are.
Great. Yeah. So if you also like, you know, to study in the States with a master's degree or an MBA and also like to receive a scholarship just like Philip here, then please go to www.epro360.com and book your free consultation. Yeah, Philip, thank you so much for your time. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
And I wish you all the best. Good luck. See ya. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Max. Goodbye.